Hello everyone. In this lecture, I'm going to explain a very important medicinal root that is widely marketed as sleep aid or an anxiolytic drug, which is valerian. This is for pharmacy third semester students, presented by me, Dr. Shaima Abdelgawad, lecturer of pharmacognosy, faculty pharmacy, Fayoum University in Egypt. Rhizoma valeriana, or known in English as valerian, or known in Arabic as valeriana, or nardine, or hashish el herb. In this lecture, I'm going to discuss the following topics with you: botanical and geographical origin of valerian, morphology and microscopical investigation, active constituents, chemical tests, uses, dosage, side effects, contraindication, and drug interaction, as well as products in the market. Botanical origin. Valerian consisted of the dried rhizome, stolons, and roots of Valeriana officinalis family Valerianaceae. It's usually collected in autumn and dried at a temperature below 40 degrees. Geographical origin. It's indigenous to Europe and Asia, and is cultivated in England, Holland, and Germany. Now we will see the morphological and microscopical features of valerian root and rhizome. The rhizome is dark yellowish brown externally, with few short slender lateral branches which are also detected. The roots are sometimes crowned with the remains of the flowering stem and leaf scars. Internally, usually it's firm, horny, and whitish or yellowish in color. It has a short and horny fracture, and also characterized by its distinctive disagreeable odor and camphoraceous, somewhat pungent and bitter taste. Microscopical investigation. This is a TS diagram showing the layers present in the valerian rhizome. It started with the epidermis layer, and in old rhizome it is converted to cork layer, followed by the layer of hypodermis, then the white cortex layer, characterized by the presence of several oil cells. The innermost layer of the cortex layer is detected as endodermis, and then the steel region, characterized by sclerenchymatous pericycle, encircling the vascular bundle constituted of phloem, xylem, and finally the base in the center of the TS diagram. We can characterize here also abnormal structure present in the center or in the base region, which is sclerites, as we will see in the next slides. This is the powder of valerian root, characterized by the presence of occasional rectangular sclerites with moderately thickened walls and large lumen from the stem base. This is from the rhizome pericyclic sclerite. Also a spiral reticulate or pitted lignified xylem vessels. Sclerites, another type of sclerites present, which present inside the base region. This one, it is with thick wall and narrow lumen. Also starch granules are detected. They are simple compound. Simple or compound, its shape is rounded and sometimes it's irregular in shape with distinct cleft or fissured hilum. Root hair also is detected in the epidermis of the root of valerian. This is only from the root, but the epidermis or cork cells from the rhizome don't contain the root hair. Active constituents in valerian. It showed the different classes of active constituent. The first class is volatile oil from 0.5 to 2%. containing the major active constituent in volatile oil is known as burnyl isovalerianate. When this compound, when we go to dry the valerian root or rhizome, this compound decomposes by the action of the enzymes inside the root to form another compound known as isovaleric acid, which is oily liquid and responsible for the unpleasant or disagreeable odor of valerian which appeared on drying. So the fresh valerian root don't have unpleasant odor, while the dry one have this unpleasant or bad odor due to the decomposition of burnyl isovalerianate to isovaleric acid, which have this bad odor, which has this bad odor. Also, two alkaloids have been detected in a valerian root known as valerianine and cotinine. Epoxy iridoid esters is a very important class of compounds present in valerian root, and it will be responsible for the biological activities that will be discussed later on the next slides. The major secoiridoid or epoxy iridoid ester present in valerian root is known as valerotriates. And as we said previously, it's responsible for the sedative effect of valerian, as will be discussed later on the next slides. Another compounds present in valerian root identified as sesquiterpene alcohol or valerianol. Uses. Valerian has been used for a long time as a herbal therapy for the treatment of sleep disorders, insomnia, and also for treatment of anxiety. This is a pharmaceutical dosage form available in Egypt here since long time, containing valerian and hops extract for the treatment of insomnia and anxiety. So the first and most important use of valerian root is as sedative due to its valerotriate, the epoxy secoiridoid ester. It's used as alternative treatment for insomnia. It's alternative for the synthetic sedatives such as benzodiazepine. It's also used as a relaxant. It relaxes the muscles, a calming effect on the central nervous system due to the terpenes of volatile oil content. It relieves many symptoms of anxiety, including tremors, palpitation of the heart, and sweating. It also may help in the healing of epilepsy and hysteria due to its CNS calming effect, and as well it's used as carminative and spasmolytic agent. The dosage. You can use valerian extract for its sedative or anxiolytic effect at the dose of 300-600 milligram up to 6 weeks. Side effects. Valerian is usually well tolerated, but some common side effects may include dizziness, drowsiness, headache, stomach upset, mental dullness, and vivid dreams. It may cause withdrawal symptoms when discontinued after long-term use. So to avoid withdrawal symptoms after long-term use, it's best to reduce the dose slowly over a week or 2 weeks before stopping completely. Contraindications. Valerian root should be stopped in the following cases or contraindicated in the following cases. If you are going to a scheduled surgery, valerian slow down the central nervous system. Anesthesia and other medications during the surgery also affect the central nervous system. So the combined effects between anesthesia and the valerian might be harmful. And so valerian should be stopped at least 2 weeks before a scheduled surgery. Also, it's contraindicated in pregnancy and breastfeeding because we don't have enough reliable information about its safety. So, stay on the safe borders and avoid using valerian while pregnant or breastfeeding. Drug interactions. It shouldn't be co-administered with other sedatives or CNS depressants such as alprazolam or other CNS depressants. because it can result or cause too much sleepiness. Available products from valerian root in the Egyptian market. These are some examples. Dermival, this is a very old product here in pharmaceutical dosage form, and others. I hope this lecture was useful to you, and if you have any question, please write it down below this video. Thank you.